Hi everyone, I'm Krista Seiden, Analytics Advocate at Google, and today I'm joined by Dan Stone, who's a Product Manager on Google Analytics. In this quick tip video, Dan is going to walk us through the multi-channel funnel reports in Google Analytics. Now these are really important because they can actually give you more insight into that customer journey before they actually go ahead and convert on your website. So with that, I'm going to go ahead and turn it over to Dan.
Thanks, Krista. All right, so the first thing to look at is in the Conversions tab on the left-hand side of your screen, you'll see multiple sections, and one of them is labeled multi-channel funnels. Now, these can be a really powerful way to gain additional insight into what your users are doing before they convert. And of course, it really benefits if you have set up multiple different conversion types in Google Analytics so that you can look at what users are doing before they convert. So looking at the layout here, you'll see a couple different tabs. There's an overview that basically summarizes what's in the rest of multi-channel funnels. And one thing to note is that throughout all of these reports, there's a conversion picker at the top that by default has selected all of your conversions that you've defined. So if you've defined a lot of different goals, you might want to start by turning them off. Otherwise, you'll see a really high conversion rate. Often, I just focus on transactions. And so I'm going to start by looking only at transactions during this date range. You also have a filter where you can choose only transactions that were touched by one of these particular channels. Although this has some quick filters for Google channels, it also includes non-Google media, as long as you've set up your campaign tagging properly. So navigating through these reports, you'll see an assisted conversions report, which can be helpful for some marketers where you want to understand for each channel, how does it play in the user's conversion funnel? And what this basically reports is the number of times where this channel drove an assisted conversion, which was where the channel touched the user before the session in which they converted, versus how many times did this channel drive a last click conversion. In other words, when this channel was the last non-direct channel to touch this user before they converted. And some marketers like to use this assist versus last click ratio to understand how high or low in the funnel a particular channel is playing. Now, moving on through the reports, one of my favorite reports is the top conversion paths report, where you can see the actual sequence of channels that resulted in conversions. And you can actually look at every single combination of channels that resulted in conversions here. So the way to read this is, for example, in row 6, there was a sequence where there was an organic search followed by a referral that resulted in 57 conversions and $3,000 of conversion value during this time range. And again, this is using my conversion type selected, which is only looking at transactions. You also have an option to choose different path lengths here. So maybe you only want to look at path lengths 3 or more, or 10 or more even. And once we start talking about path lengths, the next two reports can be really useful to understand how long does it take users to convert on average. That's where the time lag and path length reports come into play. So these are pretty straightforward, but they can be really powerful in understanding how long it takes users to convert. So time lag breaks down your conversions by how long from when they were first seen did they take to convert. And in this example, we can see that about 50% of conversions happen in the same day. So in other words, users visit, and then within one day, they convert. But we also see that there are 30% of conversions that actually take 12 to 30 days to convert. So this is really interesting because it means that there are a significant number of my purchasers who are not purchasing at first and who might benefit from some re-engagement tactics like remarketing. The other way of looking at this, aside from time lag, is looking at the path length. So instead of looking at time to conversion, this is looking at the number of touch points or channels that were involved before the user purchased. And this might happen in a single day, or it might happen over multiple days. But it provides you another way of breaking down this data to understand what does your path to conversion look like. And so here I'll see that 31% of conversions happened in just a single touch point. And this is during this particular time range. And then when I look at 12 touch points, I'll actually see that 10% of my conversions had 12 different touch points between when they first visited in this time range and when they purchased. So all in all, this section of analytics reporting can be a really powerful way to gain more insight into what your customers are doing from when they first visit you to when they ultimately purchase or convert anywhere in between.
Yep, that was a really great overview. Thank you, Dan.